Hi guys, this is Hima Hegde, bringing to you the daily news podcast at Sosin Classes. All the news you need to know and more.
To begin with, let us look at the topics under light for today. In today's session, we will be discussing two bills, namely the Companies Amendment Bill 2020 and the Jammu and Kashmir Official Languages Bill 2020. So here's a snapshot of a headline from a news article that reads, Parliament passes several important bills, including the Essential Commodities Amendment Bill. We have already discussed about this bill, and the Companies Amendment Bill. We'll be covering about this in today's session. So the Companies Amendment Bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha in the month of March this year, passed in the Lok Sabha recently, that is on 19th of September 2020, and also this bill was passed in the Rajya Sabha yesterday, that is on 22nd of September 2020. Here's the roadmap. We'll first be looking at what is the Companies Amendment Bill 2020, then the proposed amendments under this bill, lastly the way forward. So the Companies Amendment Bill 2020 seeks to amend the Companies Act of 2013. The Companies Act of 2013 with respect to the structuring, the disclosure, that is all the facts and other details, the compliance requirements for the companies, that is the rules and regulations that a particular company would have. All these things that were defined in the Companies Act will be amended by the Companies Amendment Bill 2020. So now this act, that is the Companies Act of 2013, had certain limitations. Under this bill, these limitations will be removed. So looking at what these limitations are, we have the intermediary companies investment, that is the act limited the number of companies, the number of intermediary companies through which investments can be made in a company. Secondly, it also limits the number of layers of subsidiaries. Subsidiaries as in the holding company, that is the parent company which a company can have. So now these limitations will be removed under this bill. Most importantly, coming to the objective of this bill, the amendments proposed under the Companies Amendment Bill 2020, we'll be looking at what are these amendments, are aimed at improving the ease of doing business, improving the ease of doing honest and ethical business basically. So coming to the proposed amendments under this bill, now this portion might appear quite bulky, but whatever is important from the exam perspective is been addressed in this session. So moving on, removes penalty and imprisonment. The bill removes the penalty and imprisonment in certain offenses. We are talking of minor offenses, along with the reduction in the amount payable, that is penalty, in the reduction of the amount payable. We also have the decriminalization. Firstly, now this bill has proposed 72 amendments to the Companies Act of 2013. Now this will decriminalize various offenses which can promote the ease of doing business that we have already addressed in the objective part. So why is it important to promote the ease of doing honest and ethical business? Now this would boost the confidence of the investors. Also, it will encourage them or push them to carry out the business, as the fear of imprisonment can be reduced. It is very important to note that when we are talking about decriminalization or offenses, it is only for the minor issues and not for the ones that involve fraudery or injury to any of the public interest or the public property. Moving on, the producer companies. Before that we have the recategorization. So the changes in this bill will recategorize at least 23 offenses out of 66 compoundable offenses. So now what are compoundable offenses? These are simply the ones which will not need any court permissions. They will not require any permissions from the court and can be mediated or resolved by the disputed parties themselves. So now the compoundable offenses mentioned under the Act in case of any defaults. So the defaults again we are talking about is the ones that will not involve any element of fraudery or large public damage. So coming to the producer companies, first of all, certain provisions from the Companies Act apply to the producer companies. Now, these provisions include membership, the conduct of meetings, and the maintenance of accounts. Under this bill, all these provisions are removed. What is important here to understand what are the producer companies? So, the producer companies include companies which are engaged in production, marketing, and the sale of agriculture produce and the sale of produce from the cottage industries. So, whatever provisions they had under the Companies Act, you need not memorize all of these. The provisions that they had will be removed under this bill. Moving on, we have the direct listing in the foreign jurisdiction. So now this bill empowers the central government. It empowers the central government to allow certain classes of the Indian public companies to directly list the security classes in foreign jurisdiction. So now how is this going to help? It will help the startups to tap overseas market for raising capital. Now, coming to the financial results filing and corporate governance, the specified class of companies will have to prepare and file their financial result or the financial status of their companies and also complete the audit and review. Complete the audit and review of such financial results. So certain class of companies have to prepare a file on their financial results and financial status and also do the auditing and reviewing of such results. So why is it important? The obvious reasons would be to improve the corporate governance. Also, this would bring about transparency in the system, more transparency in the system. Next online, the penalties. There will be lesser penalties for small companies. When we say small companies, we are talking about the companies that have less turnover or less or lower share of capital. Then the exclusion from listed companies. So first of all, what are listed companies? Companies whose shares are traded in the stock market. So here, this bill will empower the central government in consultation with the SEBI, that is the Securities and Exchange Board of India, to exclude the companies issuing specific classes of securities from the definition of the listed companies. Coming to the exemptions from filing resolutions. Now the 2013 Act, that is the Companies Act, required the companies to file their resolution with the ROC, that is the Registrar of Companies, ROC. However, the banking companies were exempted from filing such resolutions. This exemption has been extended to registered non-banking financial companies and housing finance companies by the proposed bill. So lastly, the CSR, that is the corporate social responsibility. Companies with net worth, turnover or profits above a specified amount are required to constitute CSR committees. What is CSR? That is the corporate social responsibility. Now, this is a management concept whereby the companies integrate social and environmental concerns in their business operations and interactions with their stakeholders. So now these are required to constitute CSR committees and spend about 2% of their average net profits in the last 3 financial years towards its CSR policy. It is important to note that the Indian businesses spend more than 10,000 crore a year on CSR. Also, under this, the companies are mandated to constitute a CSR committee comprising at least 3 members of the board with at least 1 independent member. So this was about the proposed amendments under the bill. Coming to the way forward, the market reforms. So the availability of lands and labor reforms need to be worked at. Proper trade policy. There is a need for proper trade policy for enhancement of business opportunities. Coming to the bank recapitalization, the banks are stressed and the corporate sector is over-leveraged. Though the bank recapitalization was first good step, it has to be followed up with changes in how banks do their businesses. Lastly, the issues with the index itself needs to be looked at the level of the World Bank. So these are some of the points addressing the way forward part. So that's about it with respect to the Companies Amendment Bill 2020. Moving on, the second bill under focus for today is the Jammu and Kashmir Official Languages Bill 2020. So the news headline reads, Lok Sabha passes the Jammu and Kashmir Official Languages Bill 2020. So this bill was introduced and passed in the Lok Sabha on the same day, that is 22nd of September 2020. Here's the roadmap. We'll first address a little bit of background, then know what is the Jammu and Kashmir Official Language Bill, the significance of the same, and the constitutional provisions that are important from the examination perspective. Coming to the background, in the year 1889, one need not memorize the year. However, in the year 1889, the Dogra ruler Pratap Singh adopted Urdu as the official language of Jammu and Kashmir. Urdu replaced Persian, which had enjoyed the status of being an official language for more than three centuries. Also, the Constituent Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir continued with Urdu as its official language. Coming to the bill will include Kashmiri, Dogri and Hindi. Kashmiri, Dogri and Hindi as the official languages in the newly created Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Only English and Hindi were a part or were the official languages in that area so far. As of now, the official language is Urdu and Kashmiri is recognized as the regional language of that area. Coming to the significance, inclusion of Dogri and Hindi will not only fulfill the long pending demands of the local people but also adhere to the spirit of equality. It will also address the issue of equality or it will adhere to the spirit of equality. Coming to the constitutional provisions, now the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution lists the official languages of the Republic of India. It lists the official languages of the Republic of India. The constitutional provisions relating to the 8th schedule occur in the Article 344(1) and 351 of the Indian Constitution. Now, as per these articles, that is 344(1) and 351, the 8th schedule includes the recognition of the following 22 languages. To read them out, we have the Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, Dogri, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Konkani, Maithili, Malayalam, Manipuri, Marathi, Nepali, Odia, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Santali, Sindhi, Tamil, Telugu and Urdu. So this article wasn't as bulky as compared to the previous bill that we just discussed. So this pretty much covers everything important from the examination perspective. So the answer to the yesterday's question is option B. The prelims question for today, this is the snapshot of the DND document which you will find in the official Sourcing Classes website. Reading the question, consider the following. Reduction in the market development fee by half, offered higher MSP for the upcoming rabi crops, reduction in the rural development fee by 1/4, established state level APMC mandis to procure all the rice to sell it to the international platform, to provide a level playing field for basmati rice traders and millers from within and outside Punjab, especially in the light of the provisions of the new agriculture bills, which of the following measures are announced by the Punjab government? Option A, one only. Option B, 1, 2 and 3. Option C, 1 and 3 only. Option D, all of the above. Coming to the mains question, discuss the pros and cons of the recent Lok Sabha passed new versions of three labour codes. What are the legislative stumbles faced by the Union Territory Ladakh? Explain how the labour scheme in Tibet has echoes with Xinjiang. What is the Central Vista project and how does it aid economic revival? What official languages does the Jammu and Kashmir Official Languages Bill 2020 contain for J&K? What are the list of bills passed in Rajya Sabha amidst the boycott of many opposition parties members of the House? What does a MGNREGA construction laborer card entail issued by which state? What is Abhyas? So you'll find all the answers to the discussed questions, to the read out questions in the D&D document from the official Sourcing Classes website. Hope you found today's session informative.
Thus, leaving you all to write your answers in the comment section, it's a wrap on your news podcast. Tomorrow is another day with another news. Thank you.